The following is excerpts taken from Channel 7 Perth's exclusive interview with shark attack survivor Alex Travaglini. He spoke with reporter Jordan Cutts. Had you seen the shark before you were bitten, or was it only when you felt the bite? There was a sighting earlier in the day, which everyone got out of the water for. We monitored it for a while and it appeared it was gone. The reason perhaps that led people to go back in the water was because the shark had already swum less than a meter away from people earlier in the day, and there were about 10 people in the water. No one got attacked, so they thought perhaps the shark wasn't hungry at the time. Then we came out of the water, had a drink and something to eat. People started to go back in the water and I thought I'd do the same, thinking the shark had moved on. No one could see the shark, we were all watching the water and there was nothing there. Obviously it was a bad call. Where were you bitten? There was 5 of us back in the water. At one point a friend of mine, who was sitting 3 or 4 meters away, got scared by something and said, "There it is." He started paddling away from the area, so I started doing the same and paddling towards the shore, and 2 seconds later I felt something grab my left leg, and the struggle began. Alex Travaglini had a miraculous escape from the jaws of a suspected great white shark in Greystown. How intense was the pain? It was pretty intense, but I think the adrenaline took over and the pain was not really the main concern then. I think survival mode kicked in. All I could think of was getting rid of the bloody thing and getting back to shore. Can you talk us through the struggle where you were pulled under the water? It's sort of a little blurry. I felt it bite me once and drag me back, and then at one stage kind of let go. I started using my board as a shield to keep him from biting me again. I turned around and it bit me on the other leg. I shouted at the shark, telling him to F off. My surfboard seemed to work in the sense I was pushing against him, and I guess I threw a few punches in there as well. The last thing I remember is a friend of mine said to get rid of the board, and I remember seeing the shark right in front of me turn around. It opened its mouth and all I could think was, shove that board in its mouth and take my leash off and swim away. Luckily at that same moment a wave came just where we were and I managed to catch it and body surf into the shore. Exclusive vision, watch the moment a surfer was grabbed by what was believed to be a great white shark in Greystown yesterday. What was going through your head when it was happening? Can you believe it happened to you? It was a pretty surreal moment, to be honest. I don't think I had time to think of anything but trying to survive. Luckily there was another couple of surfers there that helped me get out of the water. At the same time they applied some tourniquets with the leg ropes as they were dragging me in, so kudos to them. I reckon if it wasn't for the fact they came to my aid, then it would have been a very different story. Thank you guys. Obviously they were really effective at getting me out of the water and putting me on a surfboard, and by that time a few people that were on the shore had seen what happened and rushed to help. Between them all they rushed to carry me up the hill, which would have been a pretty hard task. I can't believe how quickly it all happened. I'm lucky I'm alive. Residents say the rising number of sharks is scaring away tourists. Do you remember what the people on the shore were saying to you? They were all very reassuring, getting me to stay calm and relax, trying to conserve energy. Everyone was very well organized and the helicopter was sent straight away. I'm very thankful for that. Canceling the Margaret River Pro is a disaster for WAO. Spent about an hour in the helicopter, is that right? I think so. It was a pretty long trip though in my mind. Why did the trip feel so long? I was in a lot of pain by then. I think once it all settled in, I was heavily sedated and I was kind of thinking I was going to pass on to the other side. My head wasn't in the right space at the time. It was pretty scary. How relieved were you when you got to Royal Perth? I was very relieved as soon as they landed that chopper. I was very happy to open my eyes and see the sky again and not hear the noise of the blades. Are pro surfers to blame for the Margaret River Pro being cancelled? Did you know how bad your injuries were? When they were pulling me out of the water I looked down and had a good glimpse, and I think at that stage one decided I wasn't going to look down again. Were you determined to survive? Was that what you were saying to yourself? Absolutely. First thing I thought was getting in contact with my family and making sure they knew I loved them and hopefully I was going to pull through, but at the time it felt like I was fading pretty quickly and I wasn't sure if I was going to make it. Did you have a chance to speak to your partner and your kids at that point? Not at the beach. Once they carried me up I got one of my friends to call up my partner. It was a hard phone call to make, but it was very good for me to speak to them and it was very soothing to be able to speak to my kids, my mom and my family. How do you feel about going back into the ocean? Well, it's my passion and I love to do it, so obviously I would like to do it again. I'm pretty sure I will do it again, but I guess there's going to be a ghost every now and then pop in my mind. I'll keep my feet up on the board maybe next time. Two surfers were attacked in separate incidents by suspected great whites on WA's southwest today. Do you feel when you go in the water you're taking the risk? We all know as surfers that they're there. It's a risk that we all take, I guess. Just like walking on the street, there's cars driving around and if you're not careful you might get hit. It's pretty scary when you think of a shark coming to bite you, but I guess the rewards are worth the risk sometimes. You only live once. With all the debate around shark culling, do you think sharks should be left alone? I think it would be good to better understand what is going through their brains. It would be good to know why they actually bite humans when we're not their staple diet. I believe research is very important and perhaps some research as well on deterrent devices. I might be considering purchasing one of those. Anything you'd like to add? I'd like to thank everyone that helped me at the time and everyone involved here at the hospital. Clinton, the helicopter pilots, and all the ambulance volunteers that came and helped me. My neighbor was there too, and all my friends and strangers that came to my help at the time. I wouldn't be here if it wasn't for them. Cheers, guys. Hawaiian surfer John Florence had a close encounter with two big sharks while surfing off Margaret River.